好，欢迎您收看万象。最近我很荣幸参与了一个纪念2021年牙裔传统月的活动，这是由北美华府作家协会主办，乐龄会马州分会协办，全程由多世代参与，以中文和英文双语进行。活动的主题是危机与转机，来自牙裔的心声。几位作家以文学作品写出对美国社会的关怀，非常感谢华府作家协会的王志荣会长允许我们在万象节目中分两集播出。在本集节目中介绍周武平医师以及严厉先生，首先介绍华府著名的家庭医师周武平医师在疫情期间所写的文章，疫情中牙医医生的感想。
我是龚泽运，或叫做龚泽运。那么我现在事实上是北美洲华文作家协会的秘书长，我们的总会长也在这里啊，吴松景会长。那我已经出版了八本中文书。今天晚上其实是非常荣幸的，请到我们大华府的名医啊，那个周武平医生来跟我们大家做一个演讲。那他呢，他是我们这边很出名的一个家庭医生啊，在我们这边开业，也是泛亚义务门诊创办医生之一。那么他是毕业于香港培正中文中学，而且也是台湾国防医学院毕业的。那么他也是那个院士啊，就是那个内科学院，美国内科学院的院士。那么他呢，今天晚上他要跟大家演讲的题目是疫情中亚裔医生的感想。那么等一下就有周医生的录音演讲。
Thank you so much, past president of this chapter, doctor with a PhD, Julianne Gong, spelled K-I-A-N-G. You yourself are such a prolific writer, so we're very honored to have you join our event today. Her introduction of Dr. Joe was perfect. He is such a hero in our community right now, because during this pandemic, he and his team of volunteers have done so much for the housebound, homebound elders and their families. He writes from that perspective, trained from the physician's eye, but also with the heart of gold. He, I don't think, has had a day of rest during this pandemic. We're lucky to have him because he also brings something from Hong Kong. Having been raised in Hong Kong and then as an internist, family physician, a general practitioner, he had training both in Taiwan and in the United States. So we are so lucky that he has decided to reside here in the Maryland area and become our Saint Dr. Joe. So we're so lucky to be able to see his writing tonight.
I'm Zhou Ping, I'm a family doctor in Hua Fu, and also a family义工啊，今天很高兴能够跟大家讲一下我在疫情中一个亚裔医生的感触或者感想啊。在这段漫长的疫情中，我见证了不少令人唏嘘的故事，不但让我体会到生命的脆弱跟无奈，也感受到亲情的藕断丝连，感觉就是近在咫尺，但是又觉得好像遥不可及啊。那还有就是民众往往就觉得医护人员好像是病毒的携带者，常常躲避着我们，好像走过很远很远他就跟我打招呼，是很客气啊，但是不会走得很近啊。所以我们医护人员也会觉得变得很敏感，那病人更是到诊所或者到医院他觉得是很害怕，视为畏途啊，因此这样往往是耽误了病情。再加上亚裔他担心言语不通，上医院没人陪伴，所以更加害怕，但是因为这样所以受害更深。但我们身为医生也尽量用各种的方法予以劝导跟协助他们。虽然在这个困难的时机，我们也可以在困难中看得到社区人性的光辉。举个例子，就是像由义工团组成的美金环活动中心跟他旗下的泛亚义务门诊部，就是一个很好的例子。因为这个 泛亚门诊部它除了例行为有困难的病人看病之外，也鉴于政府最近给亚裔的资源相对的比较不够、啊、比起其他的族类不足，所以我们更积极的向政府部门争取、啊、成立了新冠病毒检测站，还有更重要的是说我们也有这个疫苗的接种站。那我们专门是为一些被遗忘在黑暗角落、啊、因为有些他是有困难，他不知道怎么上网、啊、他没有办法得到帮助，所以除了亚裔之外也包括其他的族裔的弱势团体，我们也为他们服务。总的来讲，美国是一个移民的、国家，也是个民主的移民国家，每一个族裔他们都做出了巨大的贡献。所以这一次的疫情、哦、对美国的伦理、哦、或者道德都是一次考验。不过当我们要修正一个错误之前，先要承认这个错误，并且要正视它、啊啊、虽然这次亚裔因为受疫情的关系、啊、被不当的歧视，但是也希望因为这样能够被正视之后变成一个转机，让大家警觉。因为我们大家共处一个屋檐下，是应该互相扶持来一起建立一个美好的家园，这是我的宗旨，我的想法，也是我的意见，就跟大家分享，希望大家喜欢，谢谢。
Once again, this translation is absolutely worth waiting for. And once again, we have a millennial friend. She's based all the way in Southern California and has decided to join us so that she can also share how this really resonated with her background and her training. So take it away, Jia Yingding, please.
Thank you, Lily. Hi, everyone. My name is Jia Yingding, and I am a hospital chaplain and organizer. I graduated with a Master's of Divinity from Harvard Divinity School in 2018, and I'm currently based in Los Angeles. And I feel so honored to read this essay by Dr. Zhou in translation. Reflections of a Chinese American Physician During the Pandemic. During this endless pandemic, I have witnessed many sad stories that have not only made me understand the fragility and helplessness of life, but have also made me experience the fraying and even rupture of the ties that bind us all, so close and yet so far. People have come to regard healthcare workers as carriers of the COVID virus and avoid us. As a result, we physicians and other healthcare workers have become sensitive to this behavior. Patients have even considered clinics and hospitals as dangerous places and therefore delayed seeking medical care. In addition, Asian Americans have been afraid to enter the hospital and being isolated, unable to have family members nearby and experiencing difficulties in communicating, thus adding to their suffering. We healthcare workers can only try our best to persuade them to seek our help. But even in this difficult situation, we can still see the bright side of human nature in our community. For example, at the Chinese Cultural and Community Service Center, CCACC, the staff of the Pan-Asian Volunteer Health Clinic, PAHC, and the Adult Daycare Day Healthcare Center, ADHC, have continued to volunteer. We have continued to provide medical care for those in need. And given the insufficient public resources for Asian Americans, we have actively sought out assistance from government agencies. We have also set up sites to test for the virus and to administer vaccinations to help the forgotten, not only Asian Americans, but also members of other vulnerable ethnic groups. The United States is a democracy made up of immigrants. Immigrants from all ethnic groups have made great contributions to this country. The pandemic has been a test of the American ethos. Before we can correct any mistake, we must first admit the mistake and face it head on. Although Asian Americans have been unjustly discriminated against because of the pandemic, we hope to be treated fairly. This could be an inflection point, an awakening. We could all live under the same roof, and we should support one another to build together a beautiful home.
Beautiful, Jiaying. Jiaying, that was just wonderful. So Yan will help us because I don't know how to say Master of Divinity, Hafu Da Xue De Suo Shi, but I don't know how to say Master of Divinity.
是的，让我为大家介绍丁嘉莹。嘉莹毕业于哈佛神学院，拥有神学硕士学位。她目前在洛杉矶是医院的牧师。嘉莹说，她很荣幸今天能以英语朗诵周医师的文章。
All of these millennials are 非常非常优秀的年轻人。Thank you again, Jiaying. So now, 龚那个博士 and Dr. Zhou 会上来，我们会谈一谈那个问题。
呀，我是龚泽韵的爷爷哈。那么那个周医师啊，你也是一个很好的作家呀。你最近写了好几篇有关疫情的文章，想请问您，就是这个背后的驱动力、动机是什么呢？请你跟我们分享。
Yeah, before I answer the question, I have to thank Lily for your translation and the beautiful reading from Jiaying. You know, honestly, I think it is even better than my Chinese version. I really mean it. Thank you. 那我回到那个龚博士的那个问题哈。主要我写这个文章的目的是希望利用这文章或者这个平台。做三件事情，第一个呢，就是表达或者是疏解我在这个疫情之间的一个感觉啊，跟我的一个意见给大家分享。第二个呢，就是刚才我也提到，就是很多尤其中国人啊，或者是亚裔啊，他们都很害怕进医院啊生病，但是我们知道，在这个疫情中，你该有病，你并不会请假，所以你该看病的时候还是要看病。我给大家一个指引。那要是你万一得到了这个新冠病的话呢，也不要恐慌啊，你应该自己知道什么情况下来保护自己。好比说你要家里备一个测氧器啦等等，或者到有问题的时候你要怎么样，要找你的家庭医生或者需要去医院，给大家一个指导。那第三点呢也是很重要，就是说。我希望讲述这个疫苗是怎么样研发的，它的研发过程，它是不是它的效果是怎么样，或者它会有什么的副作用，跟大家讲清楚，大家比较有信心啊，都会踊跃来注射疫苗，因为这样子的话，我们很快能够达到这个 herd immunity， 就是群体免疫，这个群体的免疫，希望这个疫情能够早点结束，这就是我的意愿。
您的出发点啊，算是令我很感动呀。现在请嘉莹来翻译成英文。
Thank you, Julian. So the question was, you have written recently several articles about the pandemic, and what was your motivation? And Dr. Zhou expressed that a couple points. Number one, he wanted to express the emotions of medical personnel during the pandemic.Number two, he wanted to educate the public about how to seek medical care, as well as protect their health during the pandemic. And number three, he wanted to explain the history of vaccine research and the development and their effectiveness and safety, so the public could be encouraged to feel comfortable in getting vaccinated and in then ending this pandemic as soon as possible.
谢谢嘉莹啊，您的翻译非常的贴切，非常的令人家就是产生共鸣。那我现在来请问周医生第二个问题，就是能不能请你告诉我们说，华人活动中心还有就是那个泛亚医务门诊在疫情中为这个社区做了什么样的工作，让大家能够多明白一些，请你跟我们分享。
是的，我们大家知道这个华人活动中心在这个地区都有30多年的历史了，然后这个泛亚门诊也是从2003年开始，也有快20年的历史了。那泛亚门诊基本它开始的初衷是为一些没有保险、贫穷的或者言语也有困难的人服务。但是在这个疫情期间呢， 华人活动中心跟我们门诊希望把这个服务能够 扩展开来。那当然就是除了还是用视讯跟病人看病之外，那华人活动中心作为一个这个社区的一份子，也希望能够有点贡献，所以鼓励华人能够捐钱或捐物资，他作为一个桥梁给社区的一些团体，好比说医院啊，或者是那个邮政局啦，和临终照护的一些单位啦，这样子。然后另外呢，也对一些老人家，尤其在家里面不能出来的老人家，给他带药去哦，还有带他们去看医生、送餐，甚至可以有一些居家护理啊，对，跟他们这方面的帮助。那另外还有一些老人家在家里呢，我们会给他们用那个上线，给他们一些一些上课，好比说那个这个心理方面的或者身体方面，让他们学到一些东西。但是最重要的还是我们尽量向政府那边争取一些资源，就是在那个疫苗方面的施打、啊、从三月份开始差不多定期我们都有在这方面给一些，我们目标主要是对那些很难拿到资源的这些民众啊，但除了亚裔之外，其他的这个族类要是有困难，我们也是很乐意去帮忙的。所以我们希望就像我们总统讲的，到7月4号大家很高兴一起就去庆祝国庆吧，就是这个意思。谢谢。
谢谢周医生跟我们家分享，我们家对那个华人活动中心就了解了很多。现在请佳音 please translate, 佳音。
Yes, gladly, Julian. So the question was, can you please tell us what the Chinese Culture and Community Service Center, CCACC, and the Pan-Asian Volunteer Health Clinic, PAHC, have done for our Chinese American community during this pandemic?And Dr. Zhou's reply was in several pieces. So the Chinese Culture and Community Service Center, CCACC, was actually established more than 30 years ago. And the second organization, the Pan-Asian Volunteer Health Clinic, PAHC, was established in 2003.The clinic's main purpose is to provide healthcare services for low-income, uninsured individuals with limited English proficiency. And during the pandemic, in addition to providing telehealth consultations, we expanded the scope of our services. We collected monetary donations and personal protective equipment from generous members of our Chinese American community.And donated these to area hospitals and other community service organizations. We also delivered food and medications to the elderly and provided medical and nursing services for the homebound. We also provided for the elders in our community some regular virtual programs on mental and physical health topics, and we set up a COVID-19 test site.By March of this year, we started to receive vaccines from the government, and our team of volunteers regularly helped to vaccinate individuals who had difficulty in accessing such resources.
谢谢周医师分享他的文章，也谢谢他对社区的贡献。我们先休息片刻，稍后再继续我们的节目。
您身边有许多值得您珍惜的人，您是否也想呵护他们的一生？许多妇女正为乳癌丧失性命，超过40岁的妇女罹患乳癌的几率也持续增加。如果您挚爱的妇女超过40岁，请陪她定期接受乳房 X 光检查，它是乳癌高治愈期侦测乳癌的最佳方法。迈向更健康的未来，美国癌症协会一直在您身边。
海翔，倒点茶来。
我们不应该害怕老虎，他们应该更害怕我们，因为人类的捕杀，他们濒临灭绝。
海翔，
老虎不应该成为我们的食品
茶
和药物，老虎属于大自然，请帮助我们不要让2010年成为最后一个虎年。
请抵制销售虎制品。没有买卖，就没有杀害。
海翔。 我是个护士，平常很注重身体的状况，都会定期的健康检查，但我真的没想到我竟然得子宫颈癌，就觉得为什么那么年轻就会得这病，因为我才三十几岁啊。
每个人都可能暴露在 HPV 病毒的风险里，子宫颈癌是可以预防的，现在就采取行动来保护自己。
万象在今天节目中，我们播出由华府作家协会主办、乐龄会马州分会协办的活动。接下来为您介绍著名旅美诗人阎立先生的两首诗。
The Chinese are also very famous for poetry, thousands of years, millennia. And so we're very lucky to have a live poet in the sense of Mr. Yan Li has come to us based from originally Beijing.To bring his perspective to 21st century America, life in this pandemic, life among the Asian, anti-Asian hate movement, to be able to express his thoughts and his heart. He is quite a Renaissance man. He does both painting, he does poetry. And so we are so lucky tonight to have a beautiful recording of two of his poems, and you're gonna love.We call it Lang Song in Chinese, the reciting by one of the chapter's own leaders. So we will now play the tape.
我叫高霞，是本届华府作协副会长。今天我给大家朗读阎立老师的两首诗。阎立，北京人，1985年留学美国。他是著名朦胧诗诗人、旅美画家、纽约一行诗社社长，2018年出任纽约法拉盛诗歌节主办人，同年出任纽约海外华文作家笔会会长。第一首，我的2020，我的也是医院的2020。很多人出院的机会比入院少了一次，我的也是快递业的2020。我下单，在货物的林中，物子成为了打包的阳光，我的也是居家创作的2020。诗篇和画作，不知道哪个句子或哪笔颜色可以健康地通过将来的核酸检测。我担心下笔太快，很多次没能保持好平民与政治的社交距离。我的也是各类吹哨人的2020，他们的顽强在被匆匆定论的句号里突围成逗号，接着起身成为问号，最后挺直成的惊叹号，却又被悄然锯断，成为散落在地的一串无解的引号。我的也是口罩的2020，但它拦不住趁机释放自身病毒的各种团体，到底有多少体制内外的天使被扼杀，只能期望于来年的各路正义的神探。我的也是 COVID-19 的2020，借酒浇愁的酒量喝出了我洞见平底的虚无岁月，但我还是看见了人类酒庄正在繁忙地运出一箱箱打了疫苗的2021。第二首，穷人 ，the poor person， 20块补丁 ，20 scraps of fabric， 一左一右 ，left and right， 在月光下劳动 ，under the moonlight。 laboring. 好面熟的风 so familiar the wind. 你补着 you have repaired. 残破的天空 the threadbare sky. 谢谢大家。
Such a beautiful poem that expressed all of his emotions during the 2020, the entire repetition of my 2020. He expressed so many deep thoughts about the pain, the isolation, and the fear that he felt living in New York City. So it is just an amazing use of a traditional Chinese genre of poetry to talk about something that is happening to us right now in the 21st century.
这首我的2020是否也触动了您的心弦呢？如果您有兴趣想要多了解华府作家协会或是乐龄会马州分会，他们的网址现在显示在荧幕上。非常谢谢您收看万象，如果您有任何疑问或是对我们节目的内容及题材有任何建议，请来信与我们联系。万象工作室的地址和 email ID 会在节目最后播出。感谢您继续支持万象节目，请向您的亲朋好友介绍我们的节目。我们将在日后的节目中陆续讨论一些您所关心的题材。下次再会。